So I'm at IKEA, and the plan is to go in and see what their pot situation is, and I also want to buy some rocks for pebble trays and stuff. So that's the plan. I also kind of want to see what plants they have. I don't anticipate buying anything, but I do have a coworker that just bought a brand new house, and I want to get him a plant as a housewarming present, but I'm not sure if I'm going to buy it here. I'm just kind of keeping that option open. Here I am at IKEA. Yeah, so that's the plan. I do have some KFC that I have that I'm gonna eat first because it is 5 o'clock and I basically had breakfast and no lunch. So I'm gonna eat before I shop just because, you know, I need to anyway. I got myself a Famous bowl. I remember loving these, and KFC was the closest thing to IKEA. So I'm like, oh, I remember those. I should try one of those. I will let you know how it is. that I'm back from IKEA, I want to show you what I ended up getting. So the first thing I got was this Tupperware container. It was $1.99 for the base and then $1 for the lid. And I will say this is not like the best quality in the world. The lid is not going to stay secure if, say, like I turn this upside down. It's going to fall right off. So it's not like super high quality, but I wanted to use something like this as a propagation box. And I didn't want to invest a ton, but I wanted it to have like a good height here. But also I kind of like that it has like a loose lid, so it's not like super airtight in there. So that's what I got this for, and I thought it was a pretty good deal considering. I did end up getting these Dift rocks. I ended up getting 4 packs. They were $1.99 a piece, and these are the only rocks they had. I was a little disappointed. I kind of wanted to use these for pebble trays and also kind of decoratively, but also kind of a utilitarian way, because I have some pots and some inner pots that go inside, and the seal on it is too tight so that there's no airflow getting into the pot, and so it takes a long time for the soil to dry out. And I think it's causing some problems with a few of my plants, so I wanted to increase airflow, and my solution to do that was basically to either switch the pots out if I could for something that was a little bit looser and had some gap around the outside, but also you can put some rocks in the bottom of the cash pot. You won't be able to see them, of course, but just put some rocks in the bottom so that it kind of lifts your nursery pot up a little bit and it forces that seal to unseal and allows some airflow. So that's my hypothesis. We'll see if it works. I wanted to kind of experiment, but I didn't want to get something expensive, so I thought I'd go to IKEA. I might, because this is all they had, I might actually go to like a dollar store or something like that, but generally with dollar store, or not dollar store, Dollar Tree, things like that, they come in small containers, so it's only a dollar for each, but it'll be like half this size. So relatively speaking, this is a decent deal. I'd probably buy more if I needed it, but I did buy 4 of these, and I think that'll do me for a little while. On to pots. The first one I bought is a classic, and that is I bought a 4-inch Muscat. I needed a few different 4-inch sizes because I've bought some 4-inch plants, which you can see in my unboxing from last week. So I wanted some extra pots for those to go in, and this was one. I didn't like a ton of their 4-inch pot selection that they had. They seem pretty picked over, to be honest. The 4-inch size is $2.99. This next one I found I was super into, and part of me wishes I bought another one in either a different size or another one the same one, but is this guy. So it is actually either metal or something very similar to it. It's pretty thin. It doesn't have a hole in the bottom, of course. This is meant to be either a cash pot or just for decorative purposes. And it has this little markings on there, and you can't really tell on camera too much, but on the inside of all of those grooves is actually a very thin, faint, like brownish black line in there to add some definition and to add depth. And it's super cool. This one did not have a tag near it when I went to pick it up, but I bought it without knowing the price, which is why I only bought one. But it was $5.99, and it was a pretty good deal, I think. And it actually reminds me a lot of a pot I bought locally, which is this one with my fake IKEA plant in it. But this one is a little bit different. It's got some like crackle finish to it, and this one is painted ceramic, whereas this one is just a metal pot ASMR. There you go. But yeah, it reminded me a lot of this one, which I'm a big fan of. I love gold pots. You know, with plants, everybody goes towards white. They gravitate to white. I do too, to a degree. It's just, I want something a little more than just greens and whites, and I want a little bit more dimension, but if there's too much color, it could conflict with the plant that you're buying, and it doesn't look great with the plant. So gold is one of those neutrals that I really like. You can do like your silvers or coppers or things like that. Just for my aesthetic, I really like the gold. Another pot I bought was one that I already have, and I just basically bought a duplicate, and that is this one. It has these little ridges around the outside on the top here and then smooth on the bottom. And this one isn't white. It's actually more of like a grayish cream color. It's a very nice neutral. Offsets the plants really well. Also does not have a hole in the bottom. And this one, they were having a sale on all of these. There was multiple colors and things like that, but this was the only one that had a color that would match my home, even though they had like a beautiful like emerald green one, and it was so pretty, but it just doesn't go with anything in my house, so I couldn't justify it. But this one is pretty nice, and they were on sale. This one was on sale for $5.99, which is a pretty good deal. And this one holds 6-inch pots really well. Last but not least, I did end up getting my coworker a plant, and that is this guy right here. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna have to be able to get him in frame all the way. But this is a snake plant. I don't know my snake plants very well, at least the different varieties of snake plant, but this big old thing with an 8-inch pot was only $14.99, which is a very good deal. So if you're looking for like your basic snake plants, things like that, IKEA is a really good place to get it, honestly, for that price. Even finding ones like this at Home Depot, either they're not nearly, Home Depot, Lowe's, you know, what have you, they're usually not nearly as full, and they're usually closer to like the $30 mark or $24.99, something like that. So this is a really good deal, and I really like it. The other thing is I bought a pot for it to go in. This is another one of those IKEA staples that they always have. What are they called? Nippon? It's a Nippon pot. And this one was $9.99 for the pot and $14.99 for the plant. So total for the housewarming present for the coworker is $25. Not too shabby for something this awesome and this big. I'm kind of known by a few people as the crazy plant lady, and she also has cats. I'm basically living the optimal millennial spinster lifestyle. So yeah, that's it for my IKEA haul. Thank you so much for watching. It was fun to actually get out of the house. You'll notice in the footage that I did wear a mask and gloves. When I'm in places where a lot of people are going to be searching around and touching a lot of things, I'm a little more conscious about COVID, so I want to make sure I wore gloves while I was in there, just in case you thought that was a little weird. Something like IKEA, I want to be a little more cautious. So when I went to IKEA, everything I bought was plant-related. Everything I showed you was what I purchased, and everything all together with tax was $59.24. So not too shabby. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you next time. Bye!